Following are the list of services provided by service layer. Firstly, we have communication service, offboard communication service, crypto service, memory service, and system service. After getting an understanding on ECU abstraction layer, let's now look into service layer of the layer software architecture. But before we dive in, let's first understand what are handlers and managers. A handler is a specific interface which controls the concurrent, multiple, and asynchronous access of one or more clients to one or more drivers. That is, it performs buffering, queuing, arbitration, and multiplexing. The data content is not changed by handler, and the functionality is often incorporated in driver or interface. For example, the SPI handler driver, ADC driver, etc. Do check out below videos to know more about driver and interface. Now let's understand what are managers. A manager offers specific services for multiple clients. It's needed in most cases where pure handler functionality might not be good enough to abstract from multiple clients. Compared to handler functionality, a manager can evaluate, change, or adapt the content of the data. In general, managers are located in service layer. Let's consider an example. The NVRAM manager manages the concurrent access to internal or external memory device like flash, E2PROM, etc. It also performs distribution and reliable data storage, data checking, provision of default values, etc. With this understanding, let's get into our main topic. What are different groups of software services present in service layer? Following are the list of services provided by service layer. Firstly, we have communication service, offboard communication service, crypto service, memory service, and system service. Firstly, let's look into the communication service. Communication services are a group of modules built to interface with communication driver via the communication hardware abstraction for vehicle network communication such as CAN, LIN, FlexRay, and Ethernet. Some of the major tasks that they fulfill are: they provide a uniform interface to vehicle network for communication. They provide uniform services for network management. They also provide uniform interface to vehicle network for diagnostic communication. And they hide the message properties and protocol from the application layer. Let's go a bit deeper and see the specific modules present in, for example, CAN communication service stack. In CAN communication service stack, we have CAN-NM, also called as CAN network management module. Then we have CAN state manager, CAN transport protocol, also called as CAN-DP, which are working at the interface of the communication service to communicate with hardware abstraction layer. In general, these modules help in smooth transfer, that is, manage and synchronize the network of messages from application to hardware abstraction layer. Then we have the intermediate PDU router, also called as PDUR, which routes different data to different messages based on the message and signal configurations. It can also bypass the CAN-TP layer and access the CAN-IF layer of the communication hardware abstraction. On top of PDUR, we have AUTOSAR COM and Large Data COM, which, as the name implies, are modules that handle the basic functionality to transfer COM data on PDUR. Alongside, there are diagnostic modules such as Diagnostic COM Manager, also called as DCM, and Diagnostic Log and Trace, which helps in managing and logging errors considering the diagnostic request and response sent and received by the application. Looking into the generic NM interface, the module provides APIs to interface with the NM module. It handles the task of changing network states from awake to sleep to save power. It converts the generic function calls to bus specific calls and vice versa, and also performs the role of network management coordinator. Now, before we understand IPDU multiplexer, let's first understand what are IPDU. An IPDU is an interactive layer protocol data unit. Basically, whenever the PDU protocol data unit is in the layer above the communication hardware abstraction layer, it's called IPDU. So with this understanding, the IPDU multiplexer module is responsible to combine appropriate IPDU received from COM via IPDU router to new multiplexed IPDU to send back to the IPDU router on the sender side. While on the receiver side, it is responsible to interpret the content of multiplexed IPDU and provide COM via IPDU router with its appropriate separated IPDU by tracking into account the value of the selector field. And lastly, we have secure onboard communication, also called as SecOC. The SecOC was developed to provide authentication and integrity protection of sensitive data for correct and safe functionality of vehicle system. That is, ensures that the received data comes from the right ECU and has the correct value. SecOC module aims for resource efficient and practicable authentication mechanism of sensitive data on the level of PDUs. SecOC module generally supports the use of symmetric and asymmetric method for authentication and integrity protection. In the upcoming video, we'll have a look into other software modules in system software layer. Thank you.